was born and I wasn't fine. I had internal hemorrhage. The placenta came out like a one big piece, so it wasn't the fact that some of it just was stuck inside. They couldn't stop the bleeding, so the doctor asked me whether I had been to the bathroom recently, and I was like, no, I haven't been, but I had lots of water. He said to the nurse, let's just empty her bladder and start cleaning her from the inside. That's what he did. He cleaned me out, then he stitched me up. I had a couple of stitches inside, and then two or three stitches on my outer cut, which they did. I was really, really weak and exhausted from the 7-hour labor process, but I had an easy delivery as per se. It was two or three contractions and the baby was out. It didn't hurt. It was actually a good feeling to know that I'm doing something right and I can push him out. Because if you can't push the baby out, they are just going to lay on your stomach and push the baby out themselves. So, as they've stitched me up and I was all clean and they've stopped the hemorrhage, they gave me an IV. And even when he was cleaning me, I was so sleepy that I could have fallen asleep on that delivery bed. Obviously, they didn't let me to. I've lost lots of blood, so I couldn't get up from the bed. Because after you deliver, you have to get up from the bed and walk back into the labor room and stay there for 4 hours under observation. I couldn't do that. We've tried 2 times. I've had some sugary drink to get my blood sugar back to normal, but I couldn't, so they've had to roll the bed inside the delivery room.
Yes,
baby. And take me, just slide me from one bed to the other and take me out to the labor room to be under observation. After going back to the labor room, they kept me awake for 2 hours and talking just to make sure that I'm okay. Then it was nighttime, so the nurse said, okay, go back to sleep for a bit. When she woke me up around 5 o'clock, she was like, you should try and pee. She wanted me to get up from the bed. Well, I couldn't. I stood up on my feet and I was like, okay, I won't be able to do this. She was like, lay back. And as I laid back, I said, I'm feeling nauseous. She gave me a stuff, which I vomited in, sorry. She was like, okay, I'm gonna bring you that thing that they put in the bed under you so you can pee directly in it. Well, it was such a weird sensation that I couldn't. She was like, okay, then drink, have some water, and we are going to try in about a couple of minutes. I did that. We've tried again with that bed thingy. It didn't work again. She went to the cupboard and said, like, okay, I'm going to put a catheter in because you have to empty your bladder. As she was opening that package, I was like, you know what, let's try that bed thingy again. I'm gonna try to relax and pee. Well, luckily it did work, so I didn't have to have a catheter in. And that was it. She called the newborns unit, said that I can be transferred, but bring a wheelchair because she won't be able to walk. She's really nauseous. They've sent a nurse over and took me to my room. There were 2 other mommies in the room. The babies were beside us. I was exhausted, so my baby wasn't there at the time. He was in the care of the nurses, and they've allowed me to have some more rest. And then we were able to start our new life of 3. Well, I forgot to mention that after giving birth and getting myself back to the labor room, the nurses said that they can bring my baby there to try and nurse him if I can. And since I was the only one being in the labor room and my mother-in-law was there, they allowed my husband to come in so we could spend some time together. We FaceTimed my sister, so She was able to see him for the second time because she was FaceTiming with my husband when he was actually born. So she was able to see him when they were taking him to the newborns unit. So we've tried nursing, it went kind of okay. And then, yes, hi, my daddy. And another girl came in laboring, so he had to leave. And then the whole observation process started. You're getting sleepy. Yeah, you're getting sleepy. So that was my labor and delivery story. Kind of chaotic, kind of traumatizing. I am not scared of giving births, but next time I will probably choose a private hospital where I can have some pain medication if I feel the need for it. So, in conclusion, everything went well. I got better, he got better. He was born on 22nd of August 2018 at 1:05 a.m. We are happy to have him. He's almost 9 months old. Getting a bit sleepy here, so I'm gonna just go and lay him down. And if you have any questions, or if I failed to mention something and you'd like to know more about some other things, then please leave a comment down below and I'm gonna answer the comments there. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope that you're gonna follow us along in our next videos. So please subscribe, maybe share this video if you've liked it and you find it interesting. And we'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.